of his apartment in Memphis, Tennessee by his road manager. Despite frantic efforts by ambulance men and doctors at hospital, Presley was pronounced dead 1 hour later. Here at 3XY today, the switchboard has been flooded with crying girls, women and even men, calling to see if it's really true Elvis is dead. Our man in Tennessee says Elvis Presley's heart simply gave out.
Well, the word that we have just gotten is that Dr. Jerry Francisco, the medical examiner here in Shelby County, said tonight that the cause of Elvis's death was a severe irregular heartbeat. The details of the autopsy performed at Baptist Hospital here in Memphis are still a bit sketchy and will probably be a bit sketchy for the next few days while they analyze the results in lab. But Elvis's personal physician, Dr. Jordan Acopoulos, said that there was no evidence of any illegal drug use. Acopoulos added there was no evidence of any excessive use of drugs.
At 5:05, today's weather continuing fine and mild before rain developing tomorrow. At the moment in town on a cool 15 degrees. 3XY, Age Radio News.
Elvis Presley. I guess the first thing people want to know is why I can't stand still when I'm singing. Some people tap their feet, some people snap their fingers, and some people just sway back and forth. I just sort of do them all together, I guess. Singing rhythm and blues really knocks it out. I watch my audience and listen to them, and I know that we're all getting something out of our system, and none of us knows what it is. Important thing is that we're getting rid of it and nobody's getting hurt. I want to thank all my loyal fans who have watched my performances and in that way became friends of mine. I sure appreciate your listening to my RCA Victor records. And I'd like to thank all the disc jockeys for playing. Bye-bye.
He was born Elvis Aaron Presley on January the 8th, 1935 in Tupelo, Mississippi. Elvis Presley was a child of hard times, but in many ways good times. Presley adored, loved, revered by his mother, who would walk Presley to school day in, day out, until Presley was in his early teens. Presley was a legend at 20. He was dead at 42. This program is a tribute to Elvis Presley.
Well, I heard you. Good rockin' tonight.
Have you heard the news? There's good rockin' tonight. Well, that was Presley, the hillbilly cat, in his recording of the famous Roy Brown song in 1954. And today we're going to pay special tribute to a legend in his lifetime, Presley. And to help me do so, I've brought a lifelong friend of mine along to say hello and relive old times as we look back over Presley's career. His name is Brian De Courcy. And Brian, like myself, grew up in the Presley era and have followed Presley's career since 1954 and onwards.
Thank you, Stan.
Brian, perhaps we should start with early Presley, where he got his start from, why he became the legend he certainly was before he died today.
He recorded for 23 years, from 54 up until 77, what his last known recording date was and what his last known recording songs were. We won't know, well, I don't know when we'll know, but his impact on the recording world has been the greatest impact of any recording artist, bar none. His voice was heard by more people in the entire world than any other person. That includes the wartime speeches of the great leaders, Hitler and Churchill, or any other artist like the Beatles, Frank Sinatra, or Bing Crosby.
Yeah, of course, you can't help but draw similarities between perhaps the premature death of Buddy Holly and just how much Buddy Holly still means in 1977 as to what Elvis Presley is going to mean in 1997.
That's correct.
And that legend, I don't think Brian will ever die. A lot of people said that Presley took many of his features from people like Tony Curtis, whom apparently Presley idolized in the early 50s, and that's where he got his ducktail haircut from.
Well, obviously, he grew up in the 50s, and he was a 50s kid, and it was all the big matinee thing in the 50s with James Dean and Nick Adams and Tony Curtis and all these people. Mm. But Elvis precludes all them with his hairstyle and his clothing style and his music styles.
We have a little on Presley, haven't we, talking about that famous ducktail?
We do. It's coming up now.
What about the sideburns trademark?
Well, I'm stuck with them. I had them long when I was old enough to grow them, about 16 years old.
No particular reason.
I just got stuck with them. I can't get rid of them now. What's your age, Elvis? 22.
Well, we're firing questions right and left here. Let me fire one at you. If everything folded up tomorrow, which it isn't going to by looks of things, what would you do? What would you do?
Go back to driving a truck.
You like driving a truck?
No, I don't know what I would do. That's counting your chickens before they hatch. I'd like to learn a lot about acting.
Who's your favorite actor on the screen, Elvis?
I have quite a few.
How about James Dean? Did you like him?
Yes.
What is your favorite female singer right now?
Patti Page and K-Star.
Have you considered a holiday? I mean, you've been on the go for, what, 2 years now? Just about a year and a half.
About 4 years.
4 years? Yes. Well, this throws a different light on things altogether. What happened 4 years ago? Did you get your start 4 years ago?
Yes.
Where?
In Memphis.
Is that when the first record came out?
Yeah.
What was it? That's All Right Mama or something else?
Yeah, that's the name of it. No, actually...
53?
Actually, I wasn't known at all until Colonel Parker started managing me, you see, and I got on RCA Victor and on television, and then I started being known.
Before that time, you were recording on the Sun label for Sam Phillips down in Memphis?
Yes, I was known in certain sections, you know, but I wasn't known all over.
That was your recording, which we have exclusively here at 3XY, Brian, and the Presley tapes, that excerpt. But let's trace Presley's career back to 1954, where it all started with Sun Records and Sam Phillips.
It was early 54. He went to Sun Records, a local label in Memphis, Tennessee, where a year earlier he'd recorded an acetate 78, one side called My Happiness, the other side called A Casual Love Affair. This was a birthday gift for his mother.
Oh, yes, yeah.
And this acetate served as an audition for Sam Phillips, who a year later rang him and said, we'd like you in here.
Presley got down there post-haste.
That's right. Apparently he rang 7 blocks through the city in 8 minutes.
Well, they had a 2 or 3 day recording session down there when Sam Phillips phoned Presley and got him into the studio, didn't they?
That's right.
And they couldn't get anything right.
Nothing much came out of it at all, and they called in a studio guitarist called Scotty Moore and a bass player who had another band called Bill Black.
Bill Black, yeah.
And out of this came the legendary first Sun single for Elvis Presley called That's All Right Mama.
And that was a mistake, too, because they were only fooling around with that in between other songs.
That's correct.
And Sam Phillips walked into the studio and said, that's the sound I want. Don't lose it.
Well, that's all right, Mama.
1420, 3XY. It's 5:15. You're listening to a tribute to Elvis Presley with Stan Rofe and Brian De Courcy.
With 1420, 3XY.
Brian De Courcy, my special guest on this tribute to Presley today here at 3XY. Brian, how many other records did Presley go on and cut for Sam Phillips at Sun?
Officially, he released 5 singles on Sun. There are numerous other tracks, obviously, in the vaults, which some of them have come to light over the last couple of years, but I should imagine now there will be a flood in the market of unreleased Sun material. But as I said, he did cut 5 singles, and the last official Elvis Presley single on Sun
was Mystery Train, as far as
I know. Mystery Train.
That's right. Let's play it. Well, that was the last record Presley made for Sun Records and Sam Phillips. Brian, there were 5 records there, but possibly many more, as we spoke about. How many records over a year did Sam Phillips record of Presley's? I mean, when they come out, they must have been recorded over a certain period of time.
They were recorded over a period of about 20 months and released over a period of about 13.
Yes. Well, what would make Sam Phillips sell Presley's contract to RCA Victor Records?
Well, it was just a poor, struggling little record company down south, and who happened to be caught unawares of the great onslaught
of rock and roll.
Though he was probably the prime instigator of the merging forces of black rhythm and blues and white country.
That's Sam Phillips.
Sam Phillips.
Of Sun Records. Well, he turned out people like Jerry Lee Lewis, Roy Orbison, Johnny Cash. They just kept coming.
Even Conway Twitty cut a track for him.
For him, yeah. But how much did he get out of this contract of Presley's? Like, he sold Presley's contract to RCA Victor. What was the outcome financially?
The one that instigated it all was the man who became his manager, Colonel Tom Parker.
Oh, yes, yeah.
Who virtually pressured Sam Phillips into selling Elvis Presley off to a bigger label. So obviously Elvis could see much more in Elvis than Sam Phillips could, or Sam Phillips could afford to.
Yeah.
He put the Elvis Presley up for auction.
Yeah.
Sam Phillips.
How many record companies bid for that?
Well, in the end, the big companies, Capitol, Atlantic, and Columbia, all bid for him.
And what was the final going price for
it? RCA bought his contract up and all the Sun tracks, the unissued ones and the issued ones, for the then almighty sum of $40,000. They gave Elvis $5,000 and a Cadillac.
And they gave him $5,000 and a Cadillac.
And he thought his life was made.
I suppose you know I've got a lot of cars. People have written about it in the papers, and a lot of them ask me why. Well, when I was driving a truck, every time a big shiny car drove by, it started me sort of daydreaming. I always felt that someday, somehow, something would happen to change everything for me, and I'd daydream about how it would be. The first car I ever bought was the most beautiful car I've ever seen. It was secondhand, but I parked it outside of my hotel the day I got it. I sat up all night just looking at it.
What was his first RCA Victor record?
His first RCA Victor record and his first smash right around the world, which went to number one in America immediately, number one in England within 2 weeks, and we followed here slightly later, was Heartbreak Hotel. Recorded in Nashville, February 10, 1956. Well, since my baby left...
You're listening to 1420 3XY in a tribute to Elvis Presley. It's 25 past 5.
1420 3XY. Brian De Courcy, my special guest here at 3XY on our tribute, very special tribute to the late Elvis Presley. Brian, if we talk about people that made Presley famous in America, there must have been some other outlet than just records that brought Presley to light. I'm just going back to the famous and also late Ed Sullivan.
Well, Elvis had made television appearances in Louisiana on a show called Louisiana Hayride, which is the local southern country and western come rock and roll show.
Yep.
He appeared with Steve Allen, who had a big Tonight Show across America, and also the Dorsey Brothers. But the one that made the impact above all naturally had to be... the great Ed Sullivan, the Saturday Night Show.
That's right.
And Elvis made only 3 appearances on the Ed Sullivan Show for the astronomical fee of $50,000 an appearance.
Which would have been a lot of money in those days.
Which by today's standards of inflation is worth close to $1 million US per television appearance.
Weren't there so many complaints after one appearance that Sullivan forbid Presley from moving his legs and gyrating around as he normally did on stage?
Well, that's not entirely right, Stan. He made 3 appearances on the Ed Sullivan Show, as I said. The first 2 shows was just the normal Elvis, recorded on stage, very wild, very frantic, and then there was a public outcry. It was the 3rd show that went to air January the 6th in 1957 that they shot him from the waist up.
Ah, yes, yes, and they wouldn't allow the lower half of Presley to be seen.
That's correct.
We have an historical recording of that third Ed Sullivan show, don't we, Brian?
Yes, this is Elvis's 3rd and final appearance with Ed Sullivan. Went to air live right across America on January the 6th in 57, where Elvis did a medley of 7 songs: Hound Dog, Love Me Tender, Heartbreak Hotel, Don't Be Cruel, Peace in the Valley, Too Much, and When My Blue Moon Turns to Gold Again.
Okay, here is Elvis Presley, Ed Sullivan's 3rd American nationwide television broadcast.
Now here is Elvis Presley. Ladies and gentlemen, could I have your attention, please? I'd like to say that we're going to do a sad song for you. This song here is one of the saddest songs we've ever heard. It really tells a story, friend. Beautiful lyrics. It goes something like this.